Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon. Yesterday, SpaceX landed their Crew Dragon capsule for the first time in the Gulf of Mexico with astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley on board. After what appeared to be a nominal entry and splashdown under parachute, SpaceX experienced some unexpected visitors in the form of recreational boaters. Now, in a minute, I'm going to show you the clip from yesterday along with my reaction in real time from our live stream, but I do want to point out that this is dangerous, and although it seems like everything was fine in this circumstance, it could have been disastrous. One of the main reasons is because the Crew Dragon capsule uses hypergolic fuels in the form of nitrogen tetroxide and monomethylhydrazine. These are both very toxic to humans, and these boaters could have been exposed to it if the capsule was leaking. In addition to that, there are other reasons why this could have been a problem. Wakes stirred up by the boats could have rocked the capsule around. They could have impeded recovery crews from getting to the capsule in a medical emergency. There were parachutes that were in the water that recovery crews needed to recover, and one of these boaters could have run over the parachutes. Plus, even little things like just getting in the way of the camera means that personnel back at Mission Control can't see what's happening to the capsule. People sometimes forget that these cameras are fun to watch, but they are an important engineering tool for Mission Control and engineers that aren't at the recovery site. They need to be able to see the capsule and what's going on. All right, that's enough of my rant. I'm gonna let you see how it went down yesterday and what my reaction was. You guys let me know in the comments down below what you guys thought. Here it is.
Oh, look at, we got some other ships coming in the area. I don't know what these support ships are. This is a lot more support ships than they normally have. Got some SpaceX fans that were just in the area. No, I don't think these are SpaceX fans, but wouldn't that be interesting if like some guy was out on a pontoon boat with like a, you know, just having a picnic out at the recovery area, like, hey guys, we're just watching here.
5 minutes later.
You are seeing a few more boats than expected. The team's currently working with a few private vessels in the area.
Get out of here.
Sure that they get out of there.
Get out of here. It really is. Those are private vessels. Oh my God. I was joking. I was totally joking that I thought that those were private. Those are really private vessels that are violating the NOTAMAR restrictions. Oh my God, that's so crazy. They have private vessels violating their space right now that are trying to get out of the way. People just driving by with cameras and stuff. Oh, I was totally joking about that, but that's for real. When I was watching that, I was like, there are a lot of ships out there. That's not what they did before.
SpaceX fast boats moving in.
I can't believe there are so many private boats. I don't know what the proper terminology is, but there are people out there getting selfies with the Crew Dragon in the water. That's insane.
So we are being advised that the recovery team is radioing out to the vessels in the water near Crew Dragon to vacate the area so that we're able to extract Bob and Doug safely. You know, also for the safety of those folks in the area as well, not just Bob and Doug.
Yeah, this is obviously a dynamic operation. One of the first things we do is make sure there aren't essentially poisonous fumes around the capsule, so something like this just really can endanger the whole thing, endanger the crew members, and endanger themselves. So the SpaceX team is moving in to try and get them away so they can safely recover the Dragon capsule and get Bob and Doug on deck and safely inside their medical quarters. So we can see them. They're getting a lot closer. We expect about 10 minutes or so until they should be in position. All the rigging has been affixed on the Dragon capsule. And once they arrive, they'll be able to use that hydraulic lift to get Dragon up and out of the water.
That is so crazy. Like, I was so joking that it was some random guy out there.
The recovery vessel Go Navigator is getting closer and closer to Dragon Endeavor as it awaits its recovery, or as it awaits to be hoisted out of the Gulf of Mexico. Again, we landed just off the coast of Florida near Pensacola. Maybe next time we shouldn't announce our landing zone. Oh, there we got a shot from our WB-57 plane. It looks like that area has cleared out significantly, so that is good to see.
I can't believe how many private boats were in that area. That is insane. That is so crazy. Like,
and we're
honestly,
also hearing that all of the parachutes have buoys on them, so also good news as the recovery process continues for SpaceX Demo-2.
A few minutes later.
You can see the main recovery vessel in the top right there. That's the helipad with the big SpaceX X on top. It's now backing up towards the capsule.
Certainly not to be confused with one of our landing drone ships.
Look at, oh my goodness, look
There's
at all the boats.
Of dragon, of
look
dragon
at all those
water
boats.
There in the background, along with many onlookers, certainly from a safer distance.
Oh my
at
goodness.
This, this is a live shot coming from Go Navigator.
As you could tell, I was clearly not a big fan of this. I do think, though, that the Coast Guard probably needs a bigger presence for next time around. The Coast Guard did put out a statement that said that the Coast Guard worked closely with NASA and SpaceX to plan the recovery of the Dragon crew in a way that prioritized the safety of the boating public and those involved in the recovery. Mariners were alerted to the pending hazardous operations within a specified boundary by a broadcast notice to mariners that was issued on July 29th. The establishment of an official safety zone that authorizes the Coast Guard to hold legal authority over boaters in violation of entering an area was not available due to the targeted splashdown location being outside of the navigable waterways of the United States, which in most cases is limited to 12 nautical miles from shore. Now, in their statement, they go on to say that they do have the legal authority to board vessels and enforce laws even beyond the 12 nautical mile range. But one of the problems was they just didn't have enough resources or personnel at the recovery site to do that for all those boats. So I think next time they might need a bigger presence there in order to enforce a tighter security perimeter. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.